I'll talk about the video pieces and then the vibe piece separately. So the video pieces actually came out of a project I'm a year or almost a year into doing, which is releasing a spherical video piece online every day. And I did that because I wanted to be the person in the world who had made the most spherical video. That was my first thing. I was like, I want to have the most of a thing. But, you know, it's also because, like, the more you make a thing, the more you learn about it. And I, by doing this process of making more video and more video and more video and never having to decide what it was before I made it, I learned a lot about, you know, spherical cinematography and how do you build good texture and how, you know, what is good camera placement and how do you edit together, you know, the same scene shot with multiple cameras simultaneously and a bunch of different ways of, you know, using standard flat editing software like Premiere to, you know, change video. So that has been great, just the making video every day. And then part of that is that my team specifically works on networked virtual reality. So obviously the pieces that I release are online, and, you know, we've played a lot with, like, how do you recombine those videos into libraries, and how do people interact with large libraries of videos when it's in virtual reality, and can you associate an object with a video so that you walk around a virtual environment and you see the bottle, and then that bottle leads you to a link that's a video, things like that. And so the piece that's upstairs in the Vive is also networked virtual reality, but it's one of our first pieces that's a user content generation tool, meaning that you can go online and draw things online in virtual reality, and then other people will be able to see the thing that you draw also in virtual reality. So combining, you know, like, display of virtual reality with creative instincts, which is what that project upstairs is.
Cool.